also continuing on along the Bridgewater Canal towards Manchester. First thing of interest this morning is this canal side building that's been held up with props. Bridgewater Motorboat Club. That's where they put boats to repaint them. We had some heavy rain overnight and it's turned that towpath into a literal quagmire. I'm absolutely glad that I haven't got to walk it. It's a real leafy glade, so I guess it never really gets to dry out properly because the sun never really gets here. Pleasant though. Morning. Some elaborate extensions they put on those old terraced houses, taking advantage of the scenic view over the canal. Well, there's a tree down here. If that was on the Trent Mersey Canal, that would close the whole canal off. This is wider, so it only closes over half of it. You can see where it's broken off from the main tree. Wouldn't have been good if it had been a boat going underneath that when that suddenly went. Seriously big branch that. There's a lot of more boats here and it narrows right down. London Bridge and Kitchen Pub over there. Hello. Well, this boat has got a wind turbine on the top. He's joined the Green Revolution. Well, well, this section of the canal, the edges haven't been trimmed back. It has got a bit more of a wild look to it on the edges. And this section, just by Grappenhall Bridge, it's more akin to the River Trust canals that we've been on. It's a bit more overgrown, it's not quite so wide. Well, another feature of this canal is because there's no locks, you can tick along at quite a moderate speed, just ticking over really. You cover just as much ground because you're not keep stopping for locks. Curious, there's a section here where the towpath and surrounding bank have been mown just like Wimbledon. Boats listing over. Day boat hire, speed merchants. It's smelly, I know that. Must be burning coal.
I was just going to say, is it like smell
to live there, right next to the motorway. Noise of traffic be absolutely constant. You'd never get any rest from it. Except for in COVID lockdown. Pod thing going on there, look. A looks like a lot of activity here. Yeah. Right, come jump on the boat.
Cool.
Yeah. So I'm going to put it backwards so it's not so far to the ring. And then I've got it there, just wrap it round.
Hi.
Yeah. Do it now.
Yeah.
Well, there's a pretty little corner in Lymm, some nice bedding plants there, nice cottage right by the side of the canal and the bridge. That's the view of that cottage from the other side of the canal. It's a really sweet little corner. So that's an interesting building, nice curves on it. Right by the side of the canal.
Just mooring up Emma and Chris's narrowboat. As we were walking along the towpath, it was floating away from its mooring. Pins had come out, so we're now mooring it back up for them.
Here's a little hidden corner just off the canal. Golden Fleece pub, got a nice display of flowers out the front. Quite a quaint little place this. Well, that's like a mountain stream that you'd see in the foothills of the Pyrenees running underneath the road in Lymm. That's a really pretty little place. And the Spread Eagle, that's got the look of a Pyrenees type hostelry as well. Brewery Tap, which is a micro brewery. And Pot Chivers is moored over a road, because there's a road goes under the canal here. Well, as I say, Rosie and Jim get everywhere. That's a really nice display of bedding plants, and it looks like Lymm have won gold, although that was 2022. Well, I think we moored up in the nick of time. didn't see a boat all morning, and all of a sudden there's loads of them all looking for a mooring space. Oh, it's an interesting little spiral staircase. Goes down. Wow, it's amazing what you see in the street. Well, that's a lovely old building over there as well. It just does remind me of the foothills of the Pyrenees. Well, there's Lymm Dam. It's got some history. I'll put some links in the description. So that's the expanse of water the dam's holding back. And the stream back in the village that reminds me so much of the Pyrenees comes off of this dam. Down through quite a sharp valley actually until it comes out in the town there. And that's the stream coming out from the other side of the dam on its way down into the village. So there's the old stocks, and they think a cross might have stood here since Roman times, but they're not sure. But it was refurbished for Queen Victoria's visit to the town. But that's going back a while now.